In other news, China vows to provide $3.1 million for emergency medical supplies in East and in Southeast Asia. Speaking at the ASEAN Plus 3 summit, China's premier said that Beijing is also working on a global COVID-19 data analysis platform to improve pandemic readiness in the region. China is seeking closer ties with its neighbors in the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, not least because of the many foreign direct investment projects in the region under their vast Belt and Road Initiative. Territorial disputes in the South China Sea and regional security issues have also marred Beijing's relations with the regional bloc. On Thursday, the ASEAN, together with China, agreed to upgrade their relationship to a comprehensive strategic partnership, a day after reaching a similar deal with Australia. In the United States, the Biden administration secures a new $1.75 trillion framework for economic and climate change spending. The scaled-back social spending bill was reached after U.S. President Joe Biden made a last-minute trip to Congress to get reluctant progressives to support the package. Under the deal, over $550 billion will be allotted to fighting climate change, while $400 billion will be put towards free and universal preschool. $150 billion will be used to fund affordable housing units. The new proposal is a stripped-down version of the roughly $3.5 trillion social spending plan that Biden unveiled earlier this year. Executives of some of the world's biggest oil companies are grilled during a congressional probe in the United States. As this report tells us, the firms deny that they continue to misinform the public about the huge role fossil fuels play in climate change.
For far too long, big oil has escaped accountability for its central role in bringing our planet to the brink of a climate catastrophe. That ends today.
Democratic lawmakers on Thursday grilled the country's top oil executives on climate change, claiming they spent years spreading disinformation about the role fossil fuels play in global warming and seeking pledges they will work in earnest to reduce carbon emissions. Representative Carolyn Maloney, chair of the House Oversight Committee, asked the CEOs of ExxonMobil, Chevron, BP America, and Shell if they would agree to stop spending money to oppose efforts to reduce emissions, appearing less than satisfied with BP America CEO David Lawler's response.
Will you take the pledge, yes or no?
Well, for your specific pledge, what we're pledging to do is advocate for low-carbon policies that do, in fact, take the company and the world to net zero. That's the pledge I'm willing to commit to.
Well, I'm asking if you'll stop spending money either directly or indirectly to oppose efforts to reduce emissions and address climate change. Just stop spending money.
Madam Chair.
That's on lies.
Time.
Okay, I take that you don't want to take the pledge. All right.
It was the first time that the top oil executives and the heads of the American Petroleum Institute and U.S. Chamber of Commerce answered questions about climate change in Congress under oath. Democrat Ro Khanna compared the moment to the big tobacco hearings of the 1990s, which marked a major shift in public opinion about the tobacco industry.
You are powerful leaders at the top of the corporate world at a turning point for our planet. Be better.
BP's Lawler and Shell CEO Gretchen Watkins defended their positions in part by discussing current efforts to adapt their business models to add more renewable energy and lower emissions.
At Shell, we're in action on providing lower and no carbon products to our customers.
Exxon's Darren Woods and Chevron CEO Mike Wirth also played up oil and gas as being essential for operation of hospitals, schools, and offices.
The purpose of this hearing is clear: to deliver partisan theater for primetime news.
Meanwhile, Representative James Comer, the top Republican on the committee, said the panel should be addressing inflation and high energy prices and did not mention climate change in his opening remarks. The hearing kicks off a year's worth of investigations into whether big oil deceived Americans about its role in climate change, and came as President Joe Biden heads to Scotland for UN climate talks.
China's long-awaited national plan on greenhouse gas emissions fails short of falls short of expectations. In its updated nationally determined contributions to fight climate change, China reiterated its earlier pledge to see their carbon dioxide emissions peak before 2030, before they become carbon neutral by 2060. They also formalized their commitment to raise the share of non-fossil fuels in their primary energy consumption from 20 to 25% by 2030, and to increasing their wind and solar power capacities to more than 1,200 gigawatts. But being the world's biggest emitter of greenhouse gases, experts had hoped for a more significant pledge from China ahead of the UN climate change conference in Glasgow next week. Greenpeace China says Beijing's lack of new pledges casts a shadow on the global climate effort. A new report bears some alarming news about the world's forests by showing that some of the most protected forests are emitting more carbon than they can actually absorb, thus becoming carbon emitters themselves. We have this report.
Some of the world's most protected forests are becoming carbon emitters, contributing to climate change by emitting more carbon than they absorb. That's according to a new report that's alarmed researchers. Forests are considered vital for curbing climate change due to their ability to work as so-called carbon sinks. Trees and other plants absorb carbon dioxide and emit oxygen, removing greenhouse gases from the atmosphere. But according to the report, at least 10 forests designated as World Heritage Sites, including Yosemite National Park in the US, have been net carbon emitters over the last two decades. Other net CO2-emitting forests are located in Indonesia, Australia and Russia, among other countries. The phenomenon is driven by human activities like logging and intense climate-related events such as wildfires. UNESCO investigators and researchers from advocacy groups the World Resources Institute and the International Union for Conservation of Nature analysed the data of 257 forests for a period from 2001 to 2020. They say all the World Heritage Site forests together do act as a net carbon sink. To be exact, the heritage sites had a net absorption of 190 million tonnes of CO2 annually over the 20-year period. Over the course of centuries, the forests have stored some 13 billion tonnes of carbon, equivalent to Kuwait's proven oil reserves. The new findings drew on data published by the journal Nature Climate Change in January, which mapped greenhouse gas emissions and absorption by forests globally. While just 10 of the UNESCO-protected forests were found to be carbon emitters, the report said other sites also showed clear upward trajectories in emissions.